The following program shows how to properly operate your automatic load and unload system, also referred to as ALIS. This program is presented in six sections. Section 1, System Overview. Section 2, Operating the System with and without the Barcode Reader Accessory. The barcode reader automatically selects the correct cycle. Section 3, Using the Sterilizer Chamber as a loading car return for double door sterilizers. Section 4, Using the Manual Operation Features. Section 5, Removing the ALIS table from the front of the sterilizer for chamber cleaning. Section 6, Routine Cleaning and Maintenance. Prior to watching this video, please read the ALIS Installation, Operator, and Maintenance Manual, Section 6. If you are unclear about anything contained in the manual or this video program, contact STERIS. The ALIS is ergonomically designed to help reduce injury risk. The system is used only with AMSCO 600 steam sterilizers with the following features. 26-inch by 26-inch chamber. Automated sliding single or double doors. The system can handle loads from 225 to 375 pounds per cycle, depending on the chamber size. Your ALIS will be configured during installation. The ALIS features a two-way motor and can be used with single or double door sterilizers. Double doors can be interlocked to ensure only one can be open at a time. A barcode scanner may be used to automatically select the cycle. The ALIS will be set up to either manually load and automatically unload, or automatically load and automatically unload. We'll review each option. Double door sterilizer with auto load, auto unload without a barcode reader. Auto load, auto unload with a barcode reader. Manual load, auto unload without a barcode reader. And single door sterilizer with auto load, auto unload without a barcode reader. To maximize efficiency, the optional barcode reader for automatic cycle selection is recommended. The automatic loader controls are on the right-hand side of the table. The status indicator lamp has a green ring that illuminates when loading table is docked, side shields are closed, sterilizer door is open. Use the key switch to choose automatic or manual mode. When the ALIS is in manual mode, the green ring around the four arrows is illuminated. The arrows indicate up, down, and right-left table movement. The confirm load button indicates the load is ready to be processed. When ready, an illuminated blue ring surrounds the black check mark. The red button is the emergency stop. The key on the emergency stop button resets the system. The automatic unloader has identical controls, except on the unload side. The confirm load button is used only to send an empty loading car back through the sterilizer chamber using the pass-through cycle. The load table side shields swing open to provide chamber access. If the side shield is open during table operation, the table will stop immediately as a safety precaution. The ALIS table is attached to the sterilizer using the docking station. Tables are removable to provide access for chamber cleaning and sterilizer maintenance. To begin an automatic loading cycle on an ALIS that does not have a barcode reader, select the cycle screen on the control panel. Next, connect the transfer carriage to the loader table, turning the locking handle to the right. Pull back on the handles to ensure the transfer carriage is securely locked to the table and lock the transfer carriage rear casters. Then, push the loading car onto the table until it stops. The ALIS surface has been aligned with the sterilizer chamber rail to help ensure the loading car is set in the correct position. The ALIS table has a proximity sensor that confirms the loading car is in position. To automatically load the loading car into the chamber, press the checkmarked Confirm Load button on the ALIS table. An illuminated blue ring around the button confirms activation. Choose the appropriate cycle for the instruments being processed. The load side chamber door opens, and the system moves the loading car into the chamber. You'll hear a beeping sound, indicating the automatic loading process has begun. Once the chamber door closes, the cycle starts automatically. When a cycle is complete, The sterilizer automatically detects if a sterilized load is on the unload table. If the unload table is empty, the unload side chamber door opens, and the system automatically unloads the newly processed instruments from the sterilizer. Sterilized loads should be removed from the table to a cooling area, away from air conditioning ducts. This allows the next loading car to be unloaded promptly upon cycle completion. If your ALIS is equipped with a barcode reader, the cycle selection is done automatically. Begin by displaying the cycle screen on the control panel. Place the appropriate barcode tag onto the loading car bracket. Next, connect the transfer carriage to the loader table, turning the locking handle to the right. Pull back on the handles to ensure the transfer carriage is securely locked to the table. Lock the transfer carriage rear casters. Then, push the loading car onto the table until it stops. The ALIS surface has been aligned with the sterilizer chamber rail to help ensure the loading car is in the correct position for loading. The ALIS table has a proximity sensor that confirms that the loading car is in position. To automatically load the loading car, press the Confirm Load button on the ALIS table. The ring around the button turns blue when activated. The barcode reader scans the barcode as the loading car moves through the chamber opening. The barcode tells the sterilizer which cycle to run. When the loading car is secure inside the chamber, the door closes automatically, the cycle begins, and the countdown is displayed. For double door sterilizers, the next load can be set up while the other load is being sterilized, creating a continuous workflow. When a cycle is complete, the sterilizer automatically detects if a sterilized load is on the unload table. If the unload table is empty, the unload side chamber door opens and the system automatically unloads the newly processed instruments from the sterilizer. Sterilized loads should be removed from the table to a cooling area, away from air conditioning ducts. The next loading car can then be unloaded promptly upon cycle completion. If your department is equipped with a double-door sterilizer with automatic unloading only, use the transfer carriage to manually load the next loading car. Connect the transfer carriage to the sterilizer, turning the locking handle to the right. Pull back on the handles to ensure the transfer carriage is securely locked to the table. Lock the rear casters, then manually push the loading car into the sterilizer. Close the sterilizer door and choose the appropriate cycle for the type of instruments being processed. When a cycle is complete, the sterilizer automatically detects if a sterile load is on the unload table. If the unload table is empty, the unload side chamber door opens, and the system automatically removes the processed instruments. You'll hear a beeping sound, which indicates the automatic unloading process has started. If a loading car is on the unloader table, the system will not unload the processed instruments until the previous load has been removed. Sterilized loads should be removed from the table to a cooling area, away from air conditioning ducts. The next loading car can be unloaded promptly upon cycle completion. If your department is equipped with a single-door sterilizer, use the transfer carriage to manually load the next loading car of instruments to be processed onto the loading table. Connect the transfer carriage to the loader table, turning the locking handle to the right. Pull back on the handles to ensure the transfer carriage is securely locked to the table. Lock the transfer carriage rear casters, then push the loading car onto the table until it stops. The ALIS surface has been aligned with the sterilizer chamber rail to help ensure the loading car is set in the correct position. The ALIS table has a proximity sensor that confirms the loading car is in position. To automatically load the loading car into the chamber, press the Confirm Load button on the ALIS table. The ring around the button turns blue when activated. Choose the appropriate cycle for the type of instruments being processed. The load side chamber door opens, and the system moves the loading car into the sterilizer chamber. You'll hear a beeping sound, which indicates the automatic loading process has started. Once the door closes, the cycle starts automatically. When the cycle is complete, the sterilizer automatically detects if a loading car is on the table. If the table is empty, the chamber door opens, and the system automatically unloads the processed load from the sterilizer. exercise caution as the loading car will be hot. Sterilized loads should be removed from the table to a cooling area, away from air conditioning ducts, so the next loading car can then be unloaded promptly upon cycle completion. To return an empty loading car to the clean side using the empty chamber, simply select the loading car return cycle on the cycle select screen. You'll hear a beeping sound, which indicates the automatic loading process has started. To minimize air passage between the clean and sterile sides, the sterilizer doors can be set up to interlock, so only one door can be open at a time. If a sterilization cycle is aborted or the ALIS malfunctions, you may need to use the ALIS manual operation arrows to manually remove the load. First, turn the key in the middle of the arrows to the right. The four surrounding arrow buttons light up green to indicate manual operation of the table. There is an arrow for each direction the table feeder can move: forward, reverse, up, and down. Send the table feeder into the sterilizer by pressing and holding the forward arrow button until it stops. To raise the loading car up off the chamber rails, press and hold the up arrow until the feeder motion stops. Then, press and hold the reverse arrow to unload. Set the loading car on the table by pressing and holding the down arrow until the motion stops. Remove the loading car from the table using the transfer carriage. Verify the transfer carriage is locked to the table and the rear casters are locked before manually moving the loading car onto the transfer carriage. You may need to remove the ALIS loading table from the front of the sterilizer if the chamber needs to be cleaned or if repairs are needed. First, open the chamber door, then put the sterilizer in standby mode. Disconnect the ALIS cable from underneath the table. The sterilizer will alarm when the ALIS disconnects. Silence the alarm. If the ALIS has a barcode scanner, disconnect the scanner cable underneath the front of the table. Unlock the casters. Pull the lock pin handle on the docking station upward to disengage the lock from the docking plate. Roll the ALIS table away from the sterilizer. To keep ALIS clean, periodically wipe exterior surfaces with a damp cleaning cloth and some detergent solution. Then wipe with a dry cloth. Do not use cleaners containing chlorine or abrasives. Do not rinse the ALIS with running water. Under normal operating conditions, your ALIS requires little maintenance. If you hear any unusual noises or notice a change in how your system operates, notify your supervisor immediately so repair service can be scheduled. Regular service and maintenance must be performed only by Steris or Steris-trained technicians. Any work performed by inexperienced or unqualified persons or the installation of unauthorized parts could cause personal injury, invalidate the warranty, or result in costly damage. This concludes the ALIS training program. For more information, contact your Steris account representative.